Welcome to Learn Commerce PU Online Classes. Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.
Hello. Welcome to second PUC Business Studies online classes. In my previous class, I have explained about the meaning of staffing, then HRD, that is Human Resources Management, Human Resources Department, and staffing, which is wider in scope. Then staffing process, that is steps in staffing process. And under staffing process, we have seen the recruitment process. So in today's class, we will discuss about the recruitment in detail. What is recruitment? In my previous class, I made it clear the meaning of recruitment. It is nothing but searching for the candidates for the job and making them to apply for the job. Whenever the organization starts, at the planning stage itself, we will decide how many people are required to work in the organization. What are the different positions by preparing the organizational structure? We will define the authority and responsibility of each and every person, who should report to whom, and how much power each position has, and what are the requirements of the position. And depending upon that, we will search for the suitable candidate for the position. Whenever we want the work from the people, we should check whether their qualification, experience, knowledge, it matches with the requirement of the organization. That is the position that is created in the organization, in the organizational structure. So when we inform the people that such and such vacancies are available in the organization, then and we stimulate the people to apply for the job, what we will do is we will identify where are the people that are required for us. Then we will check, we will assess whether they are capable enough to occupy that particular position which is vacant in the organization. If the answer is yes, then we will ask them, we will invite them to apply for the job in the organization. When we invite them to apply for the job in the organization, the people will rush to apply in the organization for the job. And then next process starts. So when we stimulate the people to apply for the job, and when the people, the public, those who are interested, when they apply for the job and when they submit their application, the recruitment process comes to an end. This is what the recruitment is. Let us know the meaning by analyzing the definition given by Dale Yoder, a management expert. Recruitment is a process to discover the sources and manpower to meet requirements of staffing schedule and employ effective measures for attracting that manpower in adequate numbers to facilitate effective selection of an efficient workforce. They very clearly told efficient workforce in the sense the people who meet the requirement of the organization. or the people who meet the requirement of that particular position which is vacant in the organization. So it is a process to discover, that means to search for, identify from which source we can get the people, we can get the staff for our organization, sources and manpower to meet requirements of staffing schedule. What is staffing schedule? Staffing schedule means whatever I told, that is organizational structure which we prepare at the planning stage itself. The number of people that are required for the organization to work in different positions, like one director is required, four general managers are required, maybe assistant general managers are required, managers are required, or then deputy managers, assistant managers. Likewise, we will create positions depending upon the ladder of the organization, that is structure of the organization. And what we will, that is called staffing schedule. When we decide this much of engineers, this much of assistant managers, this much of deputy managers, this much of managers are required. When we decide this, that deciding part itself is staffing schedule. Staffing schedule, that is requirement, estimating the requirement of the organization. We have searched for the sources and we have identified what type of people are required and how many people are required. That is nothing but staffing schedule. And employee effective measures, that is simply we are not calling someone, come and join in our organization. Not possible, because there are some procedures to recruit the employees. There are some, there's a, like when we apply for a job, maybe nowadays mostly online there is a application should be submitted. Maybe we have to submit some documents, photograph, then maybe we have to pay the fees, we have to upload the chalan number, that is amount deposited in bank. Like that, steps are there, that's a procedure is there, and we have to follow that procedure. That is called employee effective measures. Why we employ effective measures? To make the people apply for the job. Effective measures for attracting that manpower. We may give advertisement, we may create our own website in which we will notify that these much vacancies are available in our organization. We may give that is a telecasting, that is on television, we will give advertising stating that in our organization so and so it's such and such vacancies are available. So that is nothing but employee effective measures for attracting that manpower. Which manpower? The manpower which are required for the organization. That is suitable people meet the requirements of staffing schedule. That is that manpower we are speaking here in adequate numbers. Adequate in the sense the quantity that is required by the organization. How much people are required? Maybe 30 people, 100 people, 200 people. That is nothing but requirement of the organization in adequate numbers to facilitate effective selection of an efficient workforce. That is effective selection in the sense we have to select as per the requirement of the position that is created in the organization. The people who are required to work in the organization, what qualification, what experience and how they should be. We need hard working people. We need, sometimes you might have observed in advertisements that we need people who can work in different shifts, that is night shifts. Sometimes they will say only to work in night shifts. Those who work in that is call centers, which is American based or that is foreign country based, there we have to contact the people only during night, because in India it will be night and there it will be day. So we have to call them only during night in India, so that there we will have the daytime. In foreign country it will be daytime. So the advertisement will be given very clearly. We need telemarketing executives who are ready to work in night shifts only. So that is the requirement of the organization. So effective selection of an efficient workforce, those who are ready to accept the terms and conditions of the organization. Whatever is required for us, if they agree for that, then we can call them as efficient workforce who can give more efficiency, who can give more output, who may be more loyal to the organization, who may work for a longer period of time. That is very, very important. An employee joins today, quits after 3 months, quits after 6 months, quits after 1 year. He is a burden for the organization. Because, you know friends, where the systematic selection of employees are there, the cost of recruitment is very, very high. Cost of recruitment and selection will be very high. And again, we have to give training to that person to adjust to our organization. If after 3 months, the person took the training, we have trained him how to work, we have imparted technical skill to him. After learning everything, if the person says after 1 year, sir, I cannot work here. I have this problem, that problem. I have personal problem. Done. What can you do? Don't you think it is a waste of your time, money and effort? Yes, it is. Because you made them to apply for the job, you took the interview, then you have selected that person, and to select that person, you have rejected another application, maybe of equal, that is a weightage, or equal qualification, equal talent has been sacrificed. The other person might have joined elsewhere, and he is working very, very efficiently. And this person, after 1 year, quits the organization, is a very big loss to the organization. The organization has to do the same procedure again and again. So, working for a longer period of time is also a valid reason why we have to do a staffing schedule, and we have to select efficient workforce. So, this is called recruitment. In short, recruitment is the process whereby the prospective candidates are attracted or invited to apply for job in the organization. Once the job applications are submitted, the recruitment process comes to an end. That is the meaning of recruitment. Let me move on to the next part, that is sources of recruitment. What are the sources of recruitment? We need people. We have to appoint them. So, from where we can bring them to appoint the people in the organization, from where we can bring. That is called sources of recruitment. There are two sources of recruitment. First one is internal source. Second one is external source. Internal source in the sense, it is from within the organization. The employees who are already working in that organization, those people will be selected for the position. Maybe the organization has different branches and we have many staff in different branches. Whenever there is a need, we may utilize the same people. Like an organization has 4 branches, maybe A, B, C and D. There is excess staff here in D branch. Sales declined. So, manpower is not utilized fully. Effectively not utilized. So, what we will do is, excess staff. Maybe 2 people are excess here. They have no work. Even if we remove 2 staff, work can be easily done by the remaining staff. And there is heavy sales in, that is a C branch, branch C. What we will do, we will shift these 2 employees to C, branch C. So that there is requirement and there is excess. Here there is shortage and here there is excess. We have balance by transferring 2 staff from branch D to branch C. Your problem is solved. So that is, within the organization when employees are adjusted or they are upgraded or they are shifted to another branch or another place, that is, or another department sometimes. That is called internal source. External source is the source which is outside the organization. Which is outside the organization is called external source. So these are two sources of recruitment from through which we can appoint the people: internal source and external source. Let me take up the first one, internal source. There are two types. One is how to appoint the people from within the organization, that is from internal source. There are two types. One is promotion. Second one is transfer. What is promotion? In my previous class, I have referred this promotion and career planning steps in staffing process. There I have explained, but still let me go in detail. Promotion is nothing but promotion is the vertical upward movement of an employee. That is, from bottom to top, the employee moves to a higher ladder in the organizational structure. Like when you delegate the work to your subordinate, immediate subordinate, the subordinate will learn your job. One fine morning, you are quitting the organization. What is the option available to the management? Either promote the immediate subordinate who already knows the work, who is working within the organization, working as maybe deputy manager, and manager is quitting the job. So deputy manager can be shifted upward in the organizational ladder. That is vertical upward movement in the organizational ladder by giving more responsibilities. Of course, deputy manager and the manager, there is a difference. Manager will have more authority, more responsibility, more power, more work, and there is qualitative work than the deputy manager. And the position and status enjoyed by the manager is more than the deputy manager. And again, the reward or compensation paid to the manager is more than the deputy manager. So promotion is the vertical upward movement of an employee in the organizational structure or organizational ladder with increased responsibilities, increased status, and increased return or income or compensation. So that is called promotion. When employees are promoted, when they are eligible to do the work or eligible to accept the work or eligible to accept the challenge of higher level position. When the person knows the work of higher position, then easily that person can be promoted with higher status, higher, that is, a compensation and higher responsibilities. Remember, simply increasing the responsibilities is also a promotion. Or simply increasing the income is also a promotion. And again, simply increasing the status without any increase in the compensation is also a promotion. Because the employee will feel happy. He will feel motivated. But most positive, that is, a result will come only when the income is increased. The compensation to the employee is increased. That is promotion. When the responsibilities are increased, the person will feel like, I am the boss. I have been given more responsibilities now. Myself is different from my colleagues. That sense of belongingness to the organization will come, enters in the mind of the employee. So that is nothing but promotion. Again, increasing the status, In the place of deputy manager, the person has been promoted as the manager. Don't you think the person will feel like, yes, I was the deputy manager, now I am the manager. Isn't it? So he will feel happy to work in the organization. His morale level will increase. Morale will increase. Efficiency will increase. Ultimately, output will increase. And the output of the organization and profit of the organization also will increase. Because a dissatisfied employee is a burden on the organization. And satisfied employee is an asset to the organization. An asset to the organization. So that is about promotion. Moving on to the next one, that is a next type of internal source. Transfer. Here I told in promotion, vertical upward movement, not downward movement. Remember, it is called demotion. Demotion. Demotion means reducing the status, reducing the position, reducing the income, holding the increment. It is nothing but demotion. The reverse of the promotion. But here, lateral movement of an employee. Lateral movement of an employee in the organizational structure. That is like this. Lateral movement of an employee. It's not vertical. Here, very simple. Responsibility will not be increased. Status will not increase. And compensation will not be increased. Only the work will be changed. You can see in banks, especially in banks. I think once in a week at least they will get transferred within the department, within the branch. Like a person who is working today as cashier will be placed in the position of maybe that is a clerk. Next day, the person will be in the help desk. May I help you? Isn't it? So, that is simply changing the work of the person. Shifting the person from one department to another department with same position, same salary, same pay package. So, lateral movement of an employee from one organization to another organization. That is from maybe parent company to the branch, or from one branch to another branch, as I already told you, from branch D to branch C. There is excess staff here, there is shortage of staff. Simply we will shift these people from D branch to C branch, like that. So this is called transfer, where the person will not get more salary, person's status will not be improved. Only the thing is that the person will get a chance to learn newer activities or things. When a cashier is placed in the position of that is loan section, then the work structure will increase, that is change, but status, everything remains as it is. But that person will get an opportunity to learn how to give a loan to the customer, what is the procedure to give, what are the documents that have to be demanded from the customer. So these are all the things the person will come to know, and he will learn something new. And mostly transfer is done to make the employee to learn the job, learn other job, and also to understand the problems that are inherent in the other job. Like a person who is shifted from loan section to the cashier position, then definitely he will learn the work of cashier, and he will know the difficulties of a cashier, like that. An engineer in production department is sent to maintenance department, or a person who is working in that is a warehouse department or central excise department to general stores. So definitely the person will learn new things, new job, new activities, new style of working. So this will increase the knowledge of the person. But still the position remains as it is, the income remains as it is, status remains as it is. The person will work in the capacity of engineer only. So that is called transfer. So these are the two sources of internal source of recruitment, that is promotion and transfer. Now let us move on to what are the merits of internal sources. First one is employees are motivated. Very, very simple. When Mr. A, who was working in the position of the deputy manager, is promoted to the position of manager with higher salary, more status and increased responsibilities, don't you think the person will feel happy? Of course, definitely yes. Because those who are his colleagues like deputy managers, now they will remain as deputy managers only, and this person gets the promotion and he will be designated as the manager. He will feel proud, he will feel happy or motivated, and his morale will increase. So that is called employees are motivated when promotions are given or when internal sources are used within the organization. Everyone knows that employee, automatically one person gets promotion, definitely he will feel happy and he will be motivated to work more. Second one is simplifies the process of selection. As I already told you, to give a mass propaganda regarding the available vacancies in the organization, we have to search for different sources like newspapers, magazines, web publishing or telecasting, employment exchanges. That is, these are different sources of recruitment. Sources of recruitment which are external to the organization. So it is a very, very lengthy procedure. So what we can do is, within the organization we can select so that there is no procedure. We know the employee properly, we need not have to conduct one more interview, we need not have to make the employee to write selection test. We need not have to ask for reference or background of the employee, because the management knows it very clearly, because that person was working in the organization for the last many years. So that is simplifies the process of selection. No need to spend time and effort on selection of that employee. Third one is transfer is a tool of training. As I already told you, when the person is shifted from one position to another position, or from one job to another job, or one branch to another branch, definitely the person will learn different work. He will learn different styles of working. He will meet different bosses, those who are using their own, that is, tactics. This can be learned by the employee, which improves his knowledge and improves his skill, and that is work handling style. So that will be improved. So the person will get a training. It will be very good training, because he will come to know the work of each and every department along with the problems that are there in other jobs. It is natural. Those who are lecturers, they always say bank job is very nice, simply sitting in front of computers and doing some work. Here we have to prepare, we have to give lecture in the class, and we have to correct the assignments, we have to conduct tests, we have to correct the answer papers. And those who are working in bank, they will say only 2 or 3 hours class, if it is taken, it's done. Teachers are very happy people, they have enough time. So that is like we enter a restaurant, we order for maybe some foodstuff. When we start eating, someone else beside our table will order for some other food. While eating, we may think that food may be good, may be better than my food. I should have ordered that, like that. When we purchase cell phones, isn't it? And someone else comes with a new version, and we may feel like, yes, I should have bought that one. So always it is like a jealousy, we have to say. people will feel jealousy about others, their position. That is easy, my work is tough. So like that. So that feeling will be there in the people, and this will give clear information about the others' problems while they work. So this is a type of training. Next one is balancing the staff, that is excess or shortage, that can be easily balanced. Like I already explained, in branch D, two staff are in excess, and in branch C, there is a requirement of two staffs. So we can transfer easily from branch D to branch C, so that the requirement and shortage, that is excess and shortage, can be easily balanced through the internal source. Last one is, it is cheaper. Because we need not have to follow a lengthy procedure to recruit the employees, searching for the employees, asking them to apply for the job, then scrutinizing the applications, conducting selection tests, calling an interview panel. So that can be avoided, so that this will be cheaper source of recruitment. Moving on to the minus points, that is demerits. Decrease in fresh talent. When we search for the employees within the organization, they are already known to us. We know their in and outs, like weakness and strength. But if we appoint people from outside, external source, we may get fresh talent who are young and energetic, just completed their educational qualifications, and they are enthusiastic, they have a zeal to work in the organization. So that can be invited only when we go for the recruitment from external source. So here fresh talents are reduced in case of internal source of recruitment. Second one, lethargic attitude. People know the weakness of the organization. When they work for a longer period of time, they will come to know the weakness of the organization. Those who are lethargic, that is a lazy attitude, they will follow the same thing. They will continue in the same way. For some days, they will be like energetic, and after that, they will become the same people who were there in the organization earlier. That is, attitude will not change very easily. So that is another weakness. Third one is, all vacancies cannot be filled. Only those vacancies can be filled for which people are available in the organization. Suppose totally the technology is changed. No one who are working in the organization knows about the new technology. Then what we have to do? We have to recruit the people from outside source only, because the people who are available in the organization have no skill of that technology. So that is another weakness. We cannot fill all the vacancies, all the positions through internal source. Next one, fourth one is no competition spirit. When fresh talents enter inside, there will be competition among the staff, that is a new talent and the existing one. Existing one will think as if they are old bulls. Old bulls, they have more experience. But the fresh talent, they will come with, that is a fresh talent, and they will say, we know better than them. We are qualified enough. We are young and energetic. So we can do better than them. So that type of competition will be there among the staff, so that this will increase the output of each and every employee. Whenever there is competition among the people working in the organization, then their output will increase, their efficiency will increase, which is nothing but in turn the organization's efficiency will increase and the profit margin will increase, profit of the organization will increase. That is a point to be noted. But here we cannot see any new there is no competition in the organization, because fresh talent never enters. Then last one is frequent transfer, which affects the performance of the organization. Because whenever a person is doing good in a particular position, if he is transferred to another department or another branch, then what happens? Again, he has to learn the, he has to adjust to the new environment. New environment, new activities, new work. Takes time for him to become or acquire mastery on the activities. So this will reduce his efficiency and ultimately the organizational efficiency will decrease. These are the various, that is, demerits or minus points or disadvantages of internal sources of recruitment. I will take up the external source of recruitment in the next class. Write assignment for you. Assignment: mention the merits of internal sources. Mention the merits of internal sources. Submit your assignment on time. Thank you for watching this video.